Today I want to talk to you about matter, specifically what happens when it collides with other matter. This is a bit of equipment I built for this year's Christmas lectures to discuss the hazards of micrometeoroid impacts in space.
Firing!
Whether this is with man-made stuff or natural micrometeoroids. Micrometeoroids are tiny specks of space dust which become very dangerous at high speeds. So we built this bit of kit here to demonstrate that anything can be dangerous if it's going fast enough, even a carrot. Using this high-speed footage, we were able to clock the carrots travelling at around 100 metres per second. That's well over 300 kilometres per hour. Which is more than enough velocity to obliterate a light bulb, just in case you were wondering. But the carrot is actually travelling pretty slowly compared to things orbiting the Earth. The speed of something in a low Earth orbit, like the International Space Station, is around 8 kilometres per second. That's just under 28,000 kilometres per hour. And that's almost 100 times faster than our carrot. And at these speeds, even specks of dust can be dangerous, posing a huge risk to astronauts and spacecraft. This crack in the window of the ISS is about 7 millimetres in diameter, but is thought to have been caused by a tiny fleck of paint, no more than a few thousandths of a millimetre across. So what happens when matter collides at these extreme speeds? Why does it become so dangerous? First, we need to consider what matter is. That's easy, you might think. Matter's made of atoms and molecules, right? Well, yes and no. In a sense, matter, as we're familiar with it, is really made of chemical bonds. Because it's the bonds that determine the properties of matter, how hard it is, how strong it is, what it looks like. So when objects collide, really, it's the bonds that are interacting. It's the bonds that absorb and transmit energy through the solid to determine the outcome. Just about the strongest bonds of all are in diamonds. Even this tiny thing would require about 12,000 joules of energy to break all of its chemical bonds. But even at a speed of 300 kilometers per hour, that's roughly the speed of the carrot gun, its kinetic energy by comparison would be less than 1 joule. And that's why we saw the carrot largely surviving earlier, because bonds take so much energy to break and therefore dominate the way matter behaves in the low-speed world around us. But at the much higher speeds of space, there's just so much more kinetic energy in play. The relationship between speed and kinetic energy is a square relationship, which means that if you're going 100 times as fast, you have 10,000 times as much kinetic energy. If this diamond were travelling at around 11 kilometres per second, it would have a kinetic energy of around 12,000 joules. So a collision of this energy would be enough in principle to break every single one of its chemical bonds. What this means is that the high energy collisions of space make solid matter behave in a way that's wholly unfamiliar to us. Chemical bonds suddenly become much less important because they're just not strong enough to withstand the enormous amount of energy that each and every atom carries into the collision. Really, we have to abandon, to some extent, the concept of a solid, because solidity as a property of matter is completely dependent on bonding forces. Essentially, we have to consider objects as just a collection of unbound atoms moving along together, and when they collide, all of those atoms ricochet wildly off each other in all directions. Also, because the surrounding material doesn't have time to get out of the way, you end up with lots of atoms much closer together than they would normally be. This creates huge pressure, which is a force that doesn't just act along the direction of impact, but in all directions. What I'm describing here is basically a high-energy explosion. When we think of high-speed collisions, it's easy to imagine something like a bullet punching its way through a target and leaving a clean hole. Instead, you get this moving explosion, vaporizing matter and blasting much bigger holes in things. This test footage shows the result of a high-velocity impact between a tiny stainless steel ball and two aluminium plates. The ball is only 6 millimeters in diameter, but is travelling at a whopping 6.7 kilometers per second. This is still slower than the orbital speed of the ISS. Here you can see the dramatic aftermath of a 6.8 kilometer per second impact between a small aluminium sphere and a piece of aluminium. During these sorts of impacts, the pressure and temperatures generated can exceed those found at the centre of the Earth. And this is why tiny specks of space dust pose such a risk in space. So how do spacecraft protect themselves from impacts in space? Interestingly, they still mostly use an idea devised by astronomer Fred Whipple in the 1940s, before the space age had really got started. The Whipple Shield takes advantage of the way that impacts spread out in all directions, like explosions. Basically, you have a wall made up of several layers, And the outermost layer isn't intended to stop the projectile, just to vaporize it, basically. You then have this big gap before the next layer. This allows the vaporized cloud of material to expand so that by the time it gets to this layer, its energy and its momentum are spread out over a wide area and can be absorbed easily. As we can see here, in the first instance, with these two pieces of card together, the carrot makes it through and obliterates the egg. But with the spacing as in a Whipple shield, we do a lot better.